friendly but intense competition as the finals kicked off, with teams depending on good memory, speed and wit to stay ahead in the game. But there was one team that dominated. With great teamwork and speedy answers, Team SMU quickly took the lead and eventually emerged as quiz winners.
The champions, BizQuiz 2009, Singapore Management University.
The secret to their success? Constant reading and practicing, as well as knowing their competition.
Through their videos, we realised a lot of them are very, very strong. The way they answer, the speed and all this stuff, so we told ourselves they'll be our benchmark.
The game saw teams tackling a series of questions relating to the financial industry, world news and current affairs. The hardest part, teams tell me, was a category called Killer Question that involved a team picking another team to answer a question on behalf for points.
Who are you now going to nominate?
But there were no sore losers in this competition, with the other teams lauding SMU's performance. In fourth place was Team SIM, followed by Team NUS, who took third place. And for NTU, who came in second, the team did remarkably well despite having only three members. One of them had dropped out at the 11th hour.
We tried to strategize without her because for certain news we have been allocating to each other, and therefore we pay particular attention to them and try to get her part over and try to read among each other.
But overall, teams say they've definitely gained from this experience, realizing the importance of keeping up to date with business news.
I think they would have realized the importance of reading the newspapers. And especially now that we are going through this financial crisis, people realize that you won't get such stuff in your textbooks. You read the newspapers to know what is current.
Most of the questions that come out actually are related to current affairs, and in conversations that you have with your peers in class.
Not ladies, right?
And occasionally ladies.
How long do you spend watching the videos of your competitors?
Actually, I watch mine more often.